Hello, welcome to NewsClick. We're here to discuss today the proposal from the government to have an All India NRC. We have with us Mr. Sitaram Yechury. We're going to discuss the immediate proposal as well as look at the background of where these proposals come from. Welcome, Mr. Yechury. The first thing that comes to mind is when the Home Minister has said that we'll have a nationwide NRC, then who will be a citizen of India is the question. And from when? Is the cutoff date actually something defined?
You see, this is a very, this is something, number one, we are completely opposed to this. NRC was a specific provision, part of the Assam Accord. And it was specific to Assam, and that is what the Supreme Court, under its supervision, it was carried out in Assam. It is flawed, even what happened in Assam, seriously flawed. But nevertheless, it was confined to Assam. Now to extend this to the rest of India is opening a Pandora's box and is basically an effort to try and intensify the polarization among the people.
How would it achieve that?
Because you see, they have already started what is called the National Population Register, which is the NPR. And the NPR, by definition, the cutoff date is 1951.
Right.
So 1951 is the NPR cutoff date. Now the NPR becomes the basis for the NRC.
Yes.
Then automatically the cutoff date moves to 51.
As opposed to what the government had proposed in 2003.
Three, exactly. And now for Assam, the cutoff date is 71. Right. March 71, which is the date on which the Indira Mujib agreement took place. And that is when you said all these are legal Indian citizens. Now, if you have a 51 cutoff date, and then the statement yesterday by the Home Minister says that it will be repeated in Assam.
Yes.
So, if 51 is repeated in Assam, then there will be complete chaos. I mean, what do you do with some millions of people?
Right. So, in a sense, the citizenship bill is undoing the NRC, but then redoing it at a national scale.
No, but citizenship bill, the citizenship amendment bill is a much more dangerous thing. This is a whole package. I mean, you got to see it as a package in the sense that NRC would be there. And then the citizenship amendment bill will come saying that we will grant citizenship on the basis of religion of the people who come. Which is, number one, a complete violation of our constitution. I mean, the constitution, not only citizenship, but all the fundamental rights are given, quote, irrespective of caste, creed or sex, unquote. That is the constitution of India. The citizenship amendment bill is completely violative of that.
By saying that the illegal immigrants from our neighboring countries who are not Muslims and not Jews.
Yes, they will be given citizenship, but not Muslims. Here, more importantly, Muslims, as far as we are concerned.
Right.
So you are cutting off an entire, religious community, a religious minority. And remember, we have the second largest Muslim population in the world, which is living as a minority
in India,
under a secular democracy so far.
So does the citizenship bill also sort of attack the principle of secularism?
Of course it does.
So how does it help? Whom does it help to have this bill?
It helps the proponents of Hindu Rashtra, who have always, for nearly a century now, argued that India must be a country which is character is defined by the religious affiliation of its people. And it had a twin expression during the freedom struggle. The Islamic State of Pakistan and Jinnah, that was one expression, the Hindu Rashtra of the RSS was the other. But the Indian Freedom Movement rejected the concept of Hindu Raj, adopted a secular democratic structure. The effort since then has been to undermine this secular democratic republic and in its place bring about a set about this Hindu Rashtra or Hindutva Rashtra in today's parlance, which is a fascistic, project.
One of the critiques of the NRC when it was conducted in Assam, a very strong critique, was that it's nearly impossible for the underprivileged, for the poor, to actually have all this documentation at hand. Now, if you do it on an all-India scale, what do you think will...
It's going to be chaotic. Because you see, NRC people who've come in from neighboring countries out of distress, many of them are widows who've come in. or were widows when they came in, because of all the oppression, repression, whatever you may call it. Now, for them to come with documentation, it'll be impossible. I mean, the one documentation that they always had, which is valid so far, but was not valid for the NRC process in Assam, mm-hmm. was the panchayat's certificate that so-and-so is a resident here. Right. Now they have disallowed that. Now if you disallow that, then what else can they prove? They said you bring your heritage certificates. Mm-hmm. From where do they get them? They don't have any property, they don't have any land. So where do they get their certificate from?
Okay, so the very idea of citizenship is being altered. When you say that you are a citizen of India, then it means that you live in India. The Constitution Article 5 goes by the idea of domicile. Now they're changing it to first parentage and now descent, meaning religion. So this shift has been coming over time. How does one spread the message that there is something wrong with doing things?
Well, the message is there in our Constitution. This is wrong. Constitution is very clear. So either this effort will work, will stand, or the Indian Constitution will stand. And the Indian Constitution must stand if India has to remain what it is.
Logic behind the bill is to say that we are protecting the minorities, the oppressed minorities in the neighboring countries. Now, what happens actually in Bangladesh when you implement a law like this?
Well, in Bangladesh, there's a huge discussion on. And they claim that there are about 4 crore, that is 40 million Hindus there. If this is what you're going to do to Muslims and say that they are not citizens and send them back to Bangladesh, then you be prepared to take back these 40 million. I mean, it's chaotic. I mean, it'll be something almost like the agony that the entire country and people went through during the time of partition. I mean, cross a transmigration of people of this colossal order. I mean, it is just mind-boggling. I mean, I don't know what this government is up to. And if you make statements in the parliament as the Union Home Minister, so that has its own sanctity and validity. Right. And you make such casual remarks. And why should they be in an NRC today for the whole country when you have Aadhaar, when you have your EPIC? For the non-voter, you may say, okay, Aadhaar is there.
Right.
For all the voters, you have the EPIC.
Right.
So you have these identities and people who have bank accounts and have some financial this thing, you have the PAN cards. No, why?
There is no lack of documentation. No.
Or you have your ration cards or your BPL cards.
Right.
You know, so what is this rationale? And why? There is no justification at all for this NPR except targeting a particular section of our people. And intensifying polarization, which is, it's just playing, will play havoc with our country's unity, integrity.
Are we going back to the time of partition, the two-nation theory?
Well, this is in the sense, an expression of the same logic, that if you can have an Islamic state in Pakistan, why not India be the Hindu Rashtra? This has been the RSS point of view all through. At the time of independence, when Pakistan was created and the Islamic State was established there, the anger that Indian freedom movement rejected a theocratic, a fascistic, rabidly intolerant Hindu Rashtra of that RSS variety, that is what led to the assassination of Mahatma Gandhi.
In a way, are we coming back to that same position now?
You see, instead of moving forward, which is what progress is all about, instead of advancing in our civilizational order, we are now regressing. The choice is between the light of the future or the darkness of the past. This government is taking us behind.
How should India define citizenship? Should it be by birth? Should it be by who? Whether our parents were citizens? Should it be by any other?
No, there's a variety of ways in which you define citizenship. One is by birth, natural citizens. Number two, by your parentage. Mm-hmm. Number three, when you opted for a citizenship.
Right. By choice.
By choice.
Right.
All these options are constitutionally available and there's no need to change them.
Is there any category of people who you feel is getting excluded?
Of course there are, aren't you? Isn't it obvious?
Because we have this huge refugee crisis all over the world. And does the citizenship bill, does the NRC actually take into account what is happening on a global scale?
I don't think these are concerns that matter to the present government. They are glowing with their ideological blinkers. Convert the secular democratic republic of India into a theocratic, rabidly intolerant, fascistic Hindu Rashtra. That is their ideological objective.
And there is no logic except electoral propulsion which guides them.
And also, an ideological commitment. This is what they are committed to. And electorally, they gain because the more the sharper the polarization, the greater the consolidation of the Hindutva communal vote bank.
In India.
Yeah.
And would something similar happen in our neighborhood, in Pakistan, in Bangladesh? Would the religious right get strengthened in both the
Naturally, areas? Everywhere the reactionary forces will get strengthened.
And the impact will be on the very people who they claim to?
They came to represent. That is the tragedy.
One of the things is that many of the people they want to include through the citizenship bill, the religious denominations, they are also minorities in India. So how should the Indian people actually look at this sort of conflict?
You see, we have to decide. Either we stick to a constitutional guarantee and fundamental basis that irrespective of your caste, creed or sex, you are equal and you are a citizen. Now, if you don't recognize that, then the treatment of the other minorities, even though they may be granted citizenship, will also be under question mark.
So the question mark would be on the minorities in the neighborhood, as well as those
who are in India.
Do you think people will queue up actually seeking to enter India through the borders, if this bill actually...
It will be there. Whether they'll queue up or not, there'll be tremendous pressure.
What are the
we've seen what happened to the Rohingya Muslims from Myanmar.
Yes.
And you see, I mean, the dimensions is something I don't think people are understanding.
Right. Can you explain?
We are talking in terms of millions of people, a transmigration.
Right.
And now no country in the neighborhood or any country in the world will be able to actually absorb.
That kind of thing.
Even if they are willing. Mm-hmm. Even if they are willing. Mm-hmm. So you just, opening up a Pandora's box and you never know how to close it once it's opened. And that's why, this has to be opposed tooth and nail. And therefore our party has decided and no NRC beyond Assam.
Beyond Assam. Which was a special case.
Case on the part of the Assam agitation and the Assam Accord.
And even there actually the government didn't get, perhaps the indication is they did not get the kind of result that they wanted to
exactly.
see.
Exactly, and that's why the BJP state government is opposing this NRC in Assam.
Right. And at the national level they want to do it again.
Again.
Let's talk about the expense of undertaking these mammoth exercises.
Well, the NRC exercise in Assam alone is supposed to have cost about 1600 odd crores. That's close to 2000.
Right.
A national NRC will be 40 times larger.
At least.
That is 80,000 to 1 lakh crore of rupees. And for what purpose? These are all people who are there on your Aadhaar cards, you're there on your EPIC, you're there on your Ration cards, you're there on your BPL cards. And why go through this entire thing? Only to sharpen polarization, serve their political objective and their ideological project. Country cannot pay this price.
Thank you so much. Thanks for joining us. So, uncertain benefits and tremendous losses. Thank you for joining NewsClick, Mr. Yechury.